हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द ऑफिशियल यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ संजीवनी महाविद्यालय चापोली। हैरिस डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी, बीएससी सेकंड ईयर एंड बीएससी थर्ड ईयर स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स यू कैन सी और यू कैन डिस्कस द प्लांट वाटर रिलेशंस, फिजिकल एस्पेक्ट ऑफ वाटर एब्जॉर्प्शन, importance of water, types of water and different physical processes that are involved in the absorption of water like imbibition, diffusion pressure, osmosis, endosmosis, exosmosis, osmotic pressure, plant cell as a osmotic system, significance of osmosis in plants. Now we can discuss here the diffusion pressure deficit or suction pressure. What is diffusion pressure deficit? If some solute is dissolved in water, its diffusion pressure decreases. When some solute is dissolved in water, the diffusion pressure of water decreases. That difference between the diffusion pressure of the water, pure water, and the solution is called diffusion pressure deficit or DPD. When a plant is placed in hypotonic solution, water enters into it because of osmosis, and a result, a turgor pressure is developed. The cell membrane is stretched because of the turgor pressure. When the turgor pressure increases, the osmotic pressure is decreases. When the turgor pressure is increased, then the osmotic pressure decreases. As a cell absorb more and more water, its turgor pressure increases and the osmotic pressure decreases. When a fully turgid cell more and more water absorbed, and one stage the cells can't absorb the water because the turgor pressure is increased is equal to the osmotic pressure. And when the turgor pressure and osmotic pressures are equal, the cell stop to absorb the water. So DPD is here zero. Diffusion pressure deficit is here zero when the turgor pressure is equal to osmotic pressure. Then DPD is here zero. That is, DPD is the nothing but the thrust of more water or thrust of cell for water, thrust of cell for water, and can be expressed as DPD is equal to osmotic pressure minus turgor pressure. When DPD is zero, the entry of water will stop. Thus, it is DPD that tends to equate and represent the water absorbing ability of cell, and it is also called as suction force. Suction force or suction pressure, SF or ASP. You can understand that. When the cell is placed in the hypotonic solution कशाला म्हणायचं, सेलच्या सेलपेक्षा कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन सोल्युशनचं लो असेल, लो कॉन्सन्ट्रेटेड सोल्युशन इज नोन अ हायपोटोनिक सोल्युशन. अँड वेन अ सेल इज प्लेस्ड इन वॉटर और प्लेस्ड इन अ सोल्युशन, their concentration is lower. The osmosis is carried out. What is osmosis? The diffusion of water from lower concentration to higher concentration is known as osmosis. When cell is placed into hypotonic solution, then water enters into the cell because of simple osmosis. And when the water enters into the cell, the size or the content of water in the cytoplasm increases, and because of that, the turgor pressure is developed. And when the turgor pressure is developed, the osmotic pressure is decreased or decreases. When the turgor pressure increases, the osmotic pressure is decreases. When the cell is fully turgid, the fully turgid cell will stop the absorption of water, and in that process the turgor pressure is equal to osmotic pressure. Turgor pressure is equal to osmotic pressure, and here the diffusion pressure deficit is zero. Then what is the DPD or diffusion pressure deficit? When the diffusion pressure deficit is in some more point, then the cell absorb water. That is the actual thrust of cell for water. That is the DPD. And when osmotic pressure and turgor pressure is equal, no more absorption of water. The absorption of water is stopped. And in that stage, the diffusion pressure deficit is zero. That is, the thrust of water is nil for the cell. So actually it is a thrust of water. What is DPD or diffusion pressure deficit? It is the actually a thrust of cell to the water. And here it is described as DPD is equal to osmotic pressure minus turgor pressure. When DPD is zero, the entry of water will stop. Thus it is that DPD tends to equate and represent the water absorbing ability. म्हणजे हे डी पी डी काय आहे? वॉटर ॲब्सॉर्बिंग ॲबिलिटी ऑफ द सेल इज नोन ॲज डी पी डी, डिफ्युजन प्रेशर डेफिशिट. इट इज ऑल्सो नोन ॲज सक्शन फोर्स ऑफ द सेल और सक्शन प्रेशर ऑफ द सेल. सक्शन फोर्स और सक्शन प्रेशर ऑफ द सेल. दॅट डी पी डी और डिफ्युजन प्रेशर डेफिशिट इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द हाईट ऑफ द प्लांट or tree or organism. The DPD is directly proportional to the height of the organism or of the plant. DPD governs by two factor. DPD governs two factor, that is turgor pressure and osmotic pressure. The formula of DPD is DPD is equal to osmotic pressure minus turgor pressure, and here turgor pressure can be denoted as a wall pressure in some cases. You know that turgor pressure is always equal to the wall pressure, or wall pressure is always equal to turgor pressure. So sometimes here wall turgor pressure is denoted as a wall pressure in some cases. The term diffusion pressure deficit was coined by B.S. Mayer in 1938. Originally DPD was described as suction pressure by Rainer in 1915. It is a reduction in the diffusion pressure of water in solution. Reduction in diffusion pressure of water in a solution or in a cell over its pure state due to presence of solutes in it, and the factors opposing diffusion and the factors opposing the diffusion. Diffusion pressure deficit or diffusion pressure of pure water is maximum, and its theoretical value is 1245.69 atmosphere at standard temperature and pressure STP. For pure water, DPD and diffusion pressures are same. point out that for pure water, DPD and diffusion pressures are same. Diffusion pressure deficit of a solution is equal to its osmotic pressure. Diffusion pressure deficit of a solution is equal to its osmotic pressure. That is, DPD is equal to osmotic pressure of the solution. That DPD of a cell is influenced by both osmotic pressure and wall pressure, which opposes the endosmotic entry of water. That is, DPD is equal to osmotic pressure minus wall pressure. DPD is directly proportional to the concentration of the solution. DPD decreases with dilution of the solution. The actual pressure which a cell absorbs water is called suction pressure. What is suction pressure? The actual pressure with which a cell absorbs water is called suction pressure. Next important physical process that carried out in the plant, that is plasmolysis. What is plasmolysis? We can discuss here the plasmolysis process. If a plant cell is placed in hypotonic solution means their concentration is more than the plant cell. In this solution, the plant cell is placed. What happened? The exosmosis is carried out. That plant cell loses water, and hence here the turgor pressure of the cell is decreases, and the plasmolysis is carried out. Pressure decreases to the point where the protoplasm of the cell peels away from the cell wall. Peels away from the cell wall, leaving gaps between the cell wall and the membrane. And because of that, cells making shrink and crumple. काय होतं ज्यावेळेस आपण हायपरटोनिक सोल्युशनमध्ये ज्यावेळेस प्लांट सेल ठेवतो त्यावेळेस काय होतं? एक्झोऑस्मॉसिस कॅरीड आउट होतं. अँड बिकॉज ऑफ एक्झोऑस्मॉसिस काय होतं? टर्गर प्रेशर इज डिक्रीजेस. टर्गर प्रेशर डिक्रीजेस अँड वॉटर लॉस इज फाउंड. वॉटर लॉस इज फाउंड बिकॉज ऑफ एक्झोऑस्मॉसिस. अँड इन दिस कंडिशन the plasmolysis is carried out. In the plasmolysis, the cytoplasm that are present in the cell is peels away from the cell wall. याच्यामुळे काय होतं? The gap between the cell wall and cell membrane is carried. सेल वॉल आणि सेल मेम्ब्रेनमध्ये एक मोठा गॅप त्या ठिकाणी तयार झालेला आपल्याला आढळून येतो. याच्यामुळे काय होतं? प्लांट सेल जे आहे ते श्रिंक होते किंवा क्रम्पल झालेले आपल्याला आढळून येते. अशाच प्रकारे जर कंटिन्युअस डिक्रीज इन प्रेशर जर झालं असेल, टर्गर प्रेशर कंटिन्युअसली जर डिक्रीज झालं, तर काय होतं? द प्रोसेस इज कॅरीड आउट इज नोन ॲज सायटोरायसिस. याच्यामध्ये काय होतं? या सायटोरायसिसमध्ये कम्प्लीट कोलॅप्स ऑफ द सेल वॉल इज फाउंड. कम्प्लीट कोलॅप्स ऑफ द सेल वॉल इज कॅरीड आउट. दॅट प्रोसेस इज नोन ॲज सायटोरायसिस. आफ्टर द प्लाझ्मोलिसिस, द गॅप बिटवीन द सेल वॉल अँड द सेल मेम्ब्रेन इन प्लांट इज फिल्ड विथ हायपरटोनिक सोल्युशन. दिस is because of the solution surrounding of the cell is hypotonic. Exosmosis takes place and the space between the cell wall and cytoplasm is filled with the solute as most of the water drains away from, and hence the concentration inside the cell becomes more hypotonic. There are some mechanisms in plant to prevent excess water loss in the some way as excess water gain. Plasmolysis can be reversed. Plasmolysis can be reversed if the cell is placed in the hypotonic solution. The endosmosis is carried out and the water enters into the cell and the Sturger pressure is increased and the protoplasm is again found in normal position. Stomata that are present in the cells, stomata that are present in the plants help to keep water in the plant so it does not dry out. Wax also keeps water in the plant. The equivalent process is animal cell is called as crenation. Liquid content of the cell leaks out due to the exosmosis. The cell collapse and the cell membrane pulls away from the cell wall. Plasmolysis only occurs in the extreme condition and rarely occurs in the nature. Actually, the plasmolysis is very rarely found in the nature. It is the plasmolysis is carried out in the laboratory. Only in laboratory, when you placed the plant cell into hypertonic solution, then water oozes out from the cell and the protoplasm is, or the cytoplasm or protoplasm is found in a short ball like structure away from the cell wall. That type of cell is known as plasmolyzed cell. The plasmolysis is reversed when you placed the plant cell into hypotonic solution. The endosmosis carried out, the Sturger pressure increases and the cell attain their normal position. Plasmolysis is mainly known as shrinking of the cell membrane in hypertonic solution and great pressure. Plasmolysis can be of two types, either concave plasmolysis or convex plasmolysis. Convex plasmolysis is always irreversible, while concave plasmolysis is usually reversible. During concave plasmolysis, the plasma membrane and the enclosed protoplast partially shrinks from the cell wall due to the half spherical inverting curving pockets forming between the plasma membrane and the cell wall. During convex plasmolysis, the plasma membrane and enclosed protoplast shrinks completely from the cell wall, with the plasma membrane ends in a symmetrically spherically curved pattern. That is enough for that lecture, and that is the plasmolysis. It is very important process examination point of view. Thank you.